We all remember the 80s. They were totally awesome. And the icons. They only needed one name. Springsteen. Michael. Madonna. Buddy. You say you don't remember him? Well, history certainly will. This is his story. Oh, hey.
It was early in the decade, early in the 80s, and kind of a lesser-known band. They called my agent. The band was called Devo. I'd never heard of them. I was invited to be in their video. It was for the song Whip It. So I showed up, and I'm telling you what, these cats were freaks. I get on set. These aren't normal guys. They handed me the wardrobe. That's where things kind of went south a little bit. We were wearing all black. They had red pots on their heads. I didn't get the point of the pots. The pots were upside down. So I put my pot on right side up, hoping that maybe they would see that that's the way that it should happen. Seemed like everything went well. At the final cut, I wasn't included. I ended up on the cutting room floor. So I guess all I would say to them is, you know what, guys, it's your loss. So the next opportunity I got, a lesser known artist, I think her name was Tony Basil or something like that, I don't know. But it was a music video for a song called Mickey. I jumped at the opportunity, showed up, cheerleaders. That's what this video was about, cheerleaders. And I'm thinking, I can do that. So I threw on the required attire, got in there. Don't know if I really truly fit in. My enthusiasm level was a little higher than the rest of the girls. Let's just put it that way. You know, ultimately what they told me when I got cut from the Mickey video was I was too perky. And you know, with the training that I received back at Berthet High School, I was a Spartan Spirit squad member, by the way. You know what? I would rather be too perky and out of the video than to be like that. I showed up on set for a little video called Beat It. I was wearing this new leather jacket that I had picked up. I walked through the door and lo and behold, Michael, he's wearing the same jacket, right? That's embarrassing for him. Me and some of the other dancers on the side, we got together and we were kind of showing off our moves. And I had come up with a move that I called backslide, right? I called it the backslide. And I showed it to him. Yeah, people, that's the moonwalk. He stole it from me. We filmed the video. I look good in the video. It airs. First time I see it, I'm not on it. Find out I got cut from that one, too. This time, because I was too street, too tough. You watch that video? These guys don't look tough. I did have an opportunity to try out for and join a boy band. They were called New Kids on the Block. Wasn't really an open audition. You had to be invited. So I showed up, did my thing. I mean, they really wanted me. Most of the guys did. So we did some test shots. So ultimately the reason that they gave me for being cut was they already had a heartthrob. So I formed my own group. We called ourselves, if I remember correctly, we call ourselves the other kids from down the block. But we just didn't take off. I guess we didn't have the right stuff. Well, the Addicted to Love video with Robert Palmer was one that I was really, really excited about. Because the concept behind it was he and then an all-girl band. And I get along great with the ladies, right? I get along great with the ladies. So I was thrilled about this one. I really was. I mean, I was excited. I thought this was definitely going to be the one. And turns out it wasn't, because... Just let me have a second. They told me I was too pretty. Too pretty to be in that video. It was too pretty. I'm done for now. So I did have maybe the most exciting opportunity for me of the decade, though, is I got a chance to work with Springsteen, the boss himself. And, well, let's just say I didn't get cut from that one. My butt speaks for itself.